What's going on, guys? This is JT here. I am over here on Transformers Earth Wars, about to open up my 4-star first aid crystal, which I'm super pumped about to get another healer in my lineup. But before I do so, I wanted to let you guys know, anybody that has not downloaded or tried Transformers Earth Wars and are thinking about doing so, y'all need to click the link in the description below of this video and download the game, and it's going to give you a huge little booster pack to start you off in the right direction. Now let's go ahead and get in here to the space bridge, use these crystals, open up this first aid, and then get into battle with them. Now the way I got this guaranteed first aid was from two weekends ago's leaderboard event, and I just haven't opened them up yet, so pretty pumped to add this big bad boy to the lineup. Sexy looking. I kind of looks like Ratchet, honestly. So we got first aid. I can't wait. I haven't even seen his ability yet. I've heard from a lot of my Alliance members that he is an amazing Autobot. So let's go ahead and go into the research lab and check out and see what he does. Because honestly, I don't even know. Let's see here. We got first aid. Deploy Medibots. Deploy 2 Medibots each with 217 health and an ability to shield friendly bots, blocking 45% of damage. Wow, that is pretty impressive. I kind of like that skill a lot. It's kind of like having a force shield like at your service at all times. So let's go ahead and add him to the squad. I'm just going to start off with the Alliance work and just add him to this squad. I'll replace the healer I got, Wheeljack. Obviously, if I struggle with the base, you know what I mean? I'll go ahead and take first aid out and put my strong Wheeljack in, but I want to test this guy out and see what kind of heals he does, and also how this mini bot, how his skill actually works. Kind of interested. I guess I wonder if those little mini bots are easy to kill, or if they can just, you know what I mean? There's got to be specific timings on how you want to use it, because you don't want to use it right before a mortar lands on that. Seems like that just probably one-shot it. So let's go ahead and throw out, let's see, what do we got here for a base? A pretty easy base for my account. So I think I'm going to throw out a couple of bots just to heal them at the start. So let's go ahead and toss out the gunners. And we'll toss out all these guys. Everybody but Jetfire. Let's go ahead and throw, I want to throw first raid out after these bots take a little bit of damage. There we go, that's a little bit right there. So let's see here. First aid coming to battle, so I'm guessing he heals just like any other healing bot. Oh, he heals with the... Oh, that's crazy. He actually heals not like any other bot. He heals like a gunner. Oh my gosh, I wasn't expecting that. So let's go ahead and throw... I'm going to throw these, I guess, on this Ultra Magnus up here. Let him take a little bit less damage, so... I don't know if that was a smart decision or not. It looks like the heal bots are still alive as of right now. I see them right there to the left. Ultra Magnus is about to go down though. So how much do each one of these things heal for, I wonder? Obviously I'm gonna have to level them up a little bit. It's only healing for 13 right now, so you can't really tell much. But I'm actually liking this healer a lot. I imagine him to be pretty freaking solid. A ranged healer like that, I wonder if he can heal over walls as well. That's kind of crazy, man. Look at those heals by first aid. Obviously, it's not that much of healing because he's only level 1, but imagine if you have this bad boy level 51. Oh my gosh, I might have to go ahead and level him up in this weekend's event. I know we have a pretty sweet weekend event coming where actually we can get the first time ever 5-star shards, which is pretty huge. I'm digging this first aid a lot. I didn't realize he was a gunner type of healer. Like, that's crazy. He just sits there and shoots your Autobots with heals? Interesting. Let's go ahead and bring him into this next battle. Hopefully we have another easy base, that way we don't get slaughtered. Actually, you know what? Let's send him in with... No, I'll just send him in with this squad again. Whatever. Men's underwear? Nice name. Attacking men's underwear, boys. Let's see, what do we got here? Another pretty low level base. I think we should get away with not really using too many skills and checking out first aid a little bit more. Let's go ahead and start off with sending some gunners. You know what I plan on doing is making a pretty solid gunner team. I mean, imagine like a bunch of gunners and then just having this guy way behind these gunners shooting heals at them. Like, that is insane right there. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna have to power level this guy. Like, this is ridiculous. I wish he was already power leveled. That way we got more of an example of how really beast he is, because this is not really that good of an example because he's healing for such low amounts. I mean, 13 per heal is obviously trash. Man, this is gonna be crazy. Let's go ahead and send in one more Jazz proc. Why not? We'll send in an airstrike right over that. Missile launcher and Jazz pretty much took care of all the rest of the base. As for this, as for his deploy metabots, I don't know what the best way to use this skill is. Like, is it best to use it back here? Is it best to use it on top of the bots? Like, okay, so these bots right here, that bot's shielded, and this bot's shielded. So I guess it's smarter to probably use it behind the bots. You don't really want to use it on top of the bots, because then it has, obviously, a way easier chance of dying, and these things do not have that much life. So, I mean, these heals are freaking insane. I was thinking maybe I was going to stick with Wheeljack even after seeing this bot, but now there's no way I can stick with Wheeljack. Yes, Wheeljack does have the stimulus boost to where it increases your attack speed and everything else, but man, I don't know. Having two extra bots just healing things along with this guy just shooting freaking gunner heals at bots? Like, what's better than that? It looks like you really only need to use this proc one time as well, as long as those med bots don't die. I see a lot of potential with this freaking first aid bot. Man, this is crazy. I can't believe how good he is. Yeah, I'm definitely going to be powering him up in this weekend's event. No questions asked. Let's go ahead and take a look at this weekend's event and see what we got. Let's see what we got here for this weekend's event. I know that, I can't remember what it's called. It's Stitch in Time, I believe is what it's called. Let's take a look and see what we got here. So we have Sea Spray and Octopunch available for, what's there available for? Crystals? Cyber Coins, I think? Let me see. Yeah, so for 600 Cyber Coins, you can get a Sea Spray Crystal, which I highly recommend not doing because Sea Spray sucks. All right, so we have a Stitch in Time. Fight for your allies. In another event, spark a 4-star crystal, and for the first time, 5-star shards, which is huge because, as you guys know, 5-star shards are like impossible to get. You have to get a 4-star dupe and able to get them. So to have those in a weekend event is pretty big for us. So I would suggest to everybody to get into a big alliance because I think it caps at 300,000 points, which really isn't that hard. I believe there's like over 300 alliances that meet those requirements on Transformers Earth Wars. So a lot of people should be getting some 5-star shards. So the start date is obviously on Friday the 4th and it ends on Sunday. 200% bot experience, which is where I am going to be leveling up this first aid. Let's see, is there anything else I wanted to show off? Let me see. Man, this first aid is just crazy. I can't believe how good this bot's going to be. Absolutely ridiculous. I have his deploy medibots at level 1. I think it's safe. Oops, I didn't mean to click out of that. I think it's safe to go ahead and level that up a bit. That's what I'm going to go ahead and do right now. Let's see here. Where is his? Oh, level 1. Yeah, we'll go ahead and upgrade this. I have 1.1 million spark. That should be more than enough. Go ahead and level this up. Get this right up. Use up all the Energon I can. I'm going to have to farm some more Energon after this. 860,000 Energon. I got him, what, level 5, level 6 now. Go ahead and get him. Ooh, I can't get him to level 7 just because of the amount of Energon I need. So I'll raid a little bit more and then I'll get back in there, maybe powering him up. I'll definitely show you guys some more gameplay as I get him to a higher level. Once this weekend events comes around, I plan on busting out, I don't know, a solid amount. I mean, I got 1,300 fuel saved up right now. Probably will be buying a little bit more because I'm falling a little bit behind on some of my Autobots. So I need to level these bad boys up. Anyway, guys, hope y'all enjoyed the review of First Aid. Let me know in the comments below if y'all want me to do more reviews on other Autobots or what you guys want me to post with Transformers Earth Wars, and I will get it done. All right, guys, I am out of here for now. Peace out, fellas.